our ushers, our food, on and on and on and on. So thank you, thank you. So we're going to be moved by the Holy Spirit, and we might want to clap, but I want to just invite you to pause and try and refrain from that, and we'll have an eruption of applause at the end of the service as well. So as good Lutherans, we can nod emphatically our love and encouragement. So even if you're not Lutheran, when at Trinity, you know, it's all good. So, yes, truly, truly, thank you. Now, a couple things to point out. Later in our service, we will be lighting candles, and there's kind of a safety protocol with this. Miss Jan, can I invite you to help me in this? So, we'll invite the one who has the candle lit to keep their candle upright, and the unlit one to dip in. Like that. So if it's lit, it's straight. If it's unlit, that just helps with elimination of wax. Very nice. Thank you. Yeah, very, very nice. And our ushers will remind you when we get to that part. And also, in case of an emergency, safety first, just remain calm. We'll invite you to exit as quickly and as safely as possible. So we have two doors here. We also have doors in the back, so kind of like in the airplane, the nearest exit might not be in front of you, but again, we will help usher everybody out safely. I think that's it, and at this point, I want to invite the lovely Jan Logan to please come up now. I can take that candle back. Okay.
Thank you, Pastor Jalene. Thank you, Mark Berg, and thank each and every one of you that is here tonight for supporting this event, as well as supporting the Lakes Crisis and Resource Center. All of the 23 women and children that are living in the shelter right now, thank you as well. So I hope you enjoy the evening, and God bless you all.
It's Christmas. We're surrounded by the spirit of Christmas. It is around us and within us as divinity, love, life, and light. Let us shine.
A little story was recorded in the sayings from the fathers of the desert by the first monks in Egypt in the year 325 AD.
Father Anthony came to Father Joseph and said, "Joseph, to the best of my ability, I keep to my rule. I fast, I pray, I meditate, I sing in thoughtful silence, working to make my heart pure. What more can I do?"
Father Joseph rose up, stretched out his hands to the heavens. His fingers became as though they were 10 lamps of fire. He said, "Why not be completely changed into fire?"
Please pray with me. My fire, my passion, my compassion, my soul, let me be a reflection of all that you are. Help me use all my talents, my strength, and my will to better the world you have charged to my care. So all people may share in the glory of God, let my light be a beacon of hope and your love.
Thank you.
The divine, what does it mean?
Rapturous, ecstatic, good and pure.
Celestial, heavenly, angelic, from God.
Our lives, our spirits, the divinity within us beckons us to bring forth our light. Hold it high, let it shine.
The divine shows the way for us to see and to feel and to share in the goodness within each of us, for the world around us, for each other, for life.
No one lights a candle and puts it in a place where it will be hidden. Put it to stand so that those who come may see the light. Therefore, if your whole body is full of light and not put dark, it will be as full of light as when a candle shines on you. Let your light so shine before all people that they may see your fine work and give glory to heaven.
Join with me in reading responsively Mother Teresa's daily prayer. Help me spread your fragrance wherever I go.
Let my soul with your spirit and life penetrate and possess my whole being so utterly that my life may be a radiance of yours.
Shine through me and be so in me that every soul will feel your presence in my soul.
Let them look up and see no longer me, but only you. Amen.
Life is short. We haven't too much time for gladdening the hearts of those who are traveling in the dark way with us. Oh, be swift to love. Make haste to be kind.
I expect to pass through life but once, if therefore there be any kindness I can show, or any good thing I could do to any fellow beings, let me do it now, and not defer nor neglect it, as I shall not pass this way again.
Love alone is capable of unifying living beings in such a way as to complete and fulfill them, for it alone takes them and joins them by what is the deepest in themselves.
Behold, my servant, whom I uphold, mine elect, whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He shall not cry out, nor cause his voice to be heard in the street. A bruised reed he shall not break. He shall bring forth justice.
Thus says the God the Lord, he that created the heavens and stretched them out, he that spread forth the earth and that which comes out of it, he that comes that gives breath to the people upon it and spirit to them that walk therein. I will open the eyes which are blind to bring out they that sit in darkness and out of the prison of their own making.
I am the Lord. That is my name. Behold, the former things are come to pass, and new things I do declare. Before they spring forth, I tell of them to you. Please stand. Sing Rejoice, Rejoice, Believers, found in your program.
Please be seated. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. You have brought abundant joy and great rejoicing.
A tiny light, a candlelight, a flame to stir mankind. A child is born, the dawn of hope. This flame becomes a blaze. Its light shines bright for all to see, its warmth for all to feel. The birth of love, the gift of life. Rejoice, have faith, believe.
Thank you.
And it came to pass in those days, there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child.
I have traveled many moonless nights, cold and weary, with a baby inside. I have wondered what I've done. Holy Father, you have come and chosen me now to carry your son.
And so it was that, while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you.
unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord showed round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
and this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward all.
And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and in the manger laid the child.
Thank you.
when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all that they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds.
Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Please stand with me and sing this lovely carol.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Clear in the darkness, a light shines in Bethlehem. Angels are singing, the sound fills the air. Shepherds are his courtiers, the poor are his people. With peace as his scepter, the love for his crown.
And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen as it was told to them.
Thank you.
The world is so big, so diverse, so complex. Who is right? What is wrong? Where am I? Do I belong? What I think, is it sound? What I say, is it heard? Is there some way to make my life worthwhile and whole?
With my God here beside me, around me, within, with his spirit infusing my soul with his light, I can see that my purpose, whatever I do, is to let that light shine so the world feels God's love.
Tell me, where is the road I can call my own, that I left, that I lost so long ago? All these years I've wondered, there's a way, there's a road that will lead me home.
Thank you.
This little light in your soul, you're gonna let it shine. You are everything that is. Your thoughts, your life, your dreams come true. You are everything you choose to be. You are as unlimited as the endless universe.
Scrooge was a wealthy man, yet he lived like a poor man, poor in spirit, his light a mere glowing ember.
This is Scrooge and Marley's place of business, I believe.
Yes, it is.
Do I have the pleasure of addressing Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley?
Mr. Marley has been dead 7 years this very night.
Oh, well, I'm certain his generosity will be well represented by his surviving partner at this festive season of the year. Mr. Scrooge, it is more than usually desirable we should make some slight provisions for the poor and the destitute. Many thousands are in need of want of comfort.
Are there no prisons?
Prisons? Yes, plenty of prisons.
And workhouses. Are they still in operation?
They are. I wish I could say they were not.
The treadmill is in full vigor?
Very busy, sir.
Good. I was afraid something had occurred to stop them in their useful course.
Yes, well, at this festive season, a few of us are endeavoring to raise a fund to buy the poor some food and means of warmth. What shall I put you down for?
Nothing.
Oh, you wish to remain anonymous?
I wish to be left alone. I don't make merry myself at Christmas, and I can't afford to make idle people merry. I support the establishments I have mentioned, and those who are badly off must go there.
Many cannot go there. Frankly, many would rather die.
Then they had better do it, and decrease the surplus population. Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Waking from his very loud snore, Scrooge sat up in bed to get his thoughts together. He pulled the bed curtains open. He established a sharp lookout round the bed. He wished to challenge his spirit on the moment of its appearance and was not to be taken by surprise. He was ready for anything. Nothing from an appearance between a baby and rhinoceros would have astonished him.
But he was not prepared for this. He was taken with a violent fit of trembling, a blaze of light which streamed upon his bed, only light. Afraid of light?
To this cold-hearted man, this was more alarming than a dozen ghosts. A voice called his name. It was his living room, no doubt about that. The room was transformed. The walls and ceilings were hung with living green. It looked like a forest, from every part of which bright gleaming berries glistened. The crisp leaves of holly, mistletoe, and ivy reflected the light.
There a mighty blaze was roaring up the chimney, which that fireplace had never known in Scrooge's time or Marley's. Heaped up on the floor to form a throne were turkeys, geese, wreaths of sausages, plum puddings, luscious pears, and seething bowls of punch, which made the chamber dim with their delicious steam. In easy state upon his throne, there sat the spirit of Christmas present, glorious to see, who bore a glowing torch in the shape like plenty's horn, held up high, shedding its light on Scrooge. Let's listen in.
Come in! Come in and get to know me better, man. I am the spirit of Christmas present. Look upon me. Have you never seen the likes of me before?
Never.
Have you ever walked with my elder brothers?
I don't think I have. You have many brothers?
More than 2,000.
Oh, I see. You wear a scabbard, but no sword.
Indeed. Peace on earth. Goodwill to men.
Spirit, conduct me where you will.
Touch my robe.
Oh, what's happening? This is very strange.
Indeed, not many mortals are granted a heavenly perspective of man's world.
Yes, it's quite beautiful. Smell that? Cooking goose. Come on. I take it this bleak pauper's dwelling is of some significance.
It's all your loyal clerk Bob Cratchit's home. All he can afford for his meager 15 bob a week.
Mother, Father, we just came by the baker shop and smelled our goose cooking. Delicious.
Shut the door, please. What happened to your precious father and your brother?
Wait till you see our goose. It's a wonderful one.
Children, off with you to the baker's and collect the bird. No dallying.
There, Father's coming.
Merry Christmas, everyone. Come on, Tim. I hear the pudding singing in the copper. Shall we have a look?
How did little Tim behave?
As good as gold and better. Somehow he gets thoughtful sitting by himself so much, and he thinks the strangest things. Why, tonight he told me he hoped that the people saw him in church because he was a cripple, and it might be pleasant for them to remember upon Christmas Day who made lame beggars walk and blind men see. I believe he grows more hearty and stronger every day, my dear. The pudding looks delicious. The whole house smells like a pastry cook's shop.
Spirit, tell me, will Tiny Tim die?
I see a vacant seat by the chimney, a crutch without an owner, carefully preserved.
Hooray, the Christmas goose, make space. Let's get that cover up.
Oh, lovely, well done. I don't believe I've ever seen a more magnificent goose cooked, that's for sure.
I hope one Christmas the children might taste a turkey.
Perhaps one day, my dear. Perhaps one day. A toast to Mr. Scrooge, the founder of the feast.
Ha! Founder of the feast indeed. I wish I had him here. I'd give him a piece of my mind to feast upon. I'd hope he had a good appetite for it.
My dear, the children, it's Christmas Day.
Christmas Day, I'm sure. How can we drink to a health of such an odious man, stingy, hard, unfeeling man, as Scrooge himself? You know how he is, Robert. Nobody knows him better than you.
My dear, it's Christmas Day. Be charitable.
Well then, a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. He'll be a very merry and very happy, I'm certain. A Merry Christmas to us all, my dears. God bless us.
God bless us, everyone.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Kind spirit, say Tiny Tim will be spared.
If these shadows remain unaltered by the future, the child will die.
Die? No, spirit. Say he will be spared.
What then? If he is to die, he'd better do it and decrease the surplus population.
Yes, that. I have said it. Spirit, hear me. I am not the man I was.
The spirit of Christmas present visits us every year, as the spirit of Christmas will visit Ebenezer Scrooge shortly. How do we feel its wonder? Scrooge, even in his earlier, happier days, missed the spirit of Christmas.
O Lord, look down from heaven and see that we are all your people.
Everyone to his or her own way.
Send out your light and truth and let them both lead us.
Lord, let the radiance of your light shine on all the people.
Thank you.
The ushers will now be coming round to collect a free will offering for the children of the Lakes Crisis Center.
Cure for all the ills and wrongs, the cares, the sorrows, and crimes of humanity all lie in that one word, love. It is the divine vitality which produces and restores life to each other and every one of us. It gives the power of working miracles if we will.
For the right person, at the right moment, we each can have an impact, sometimes profound. We cannot necessarily even anticipate when or how or to whom that might be. So to give of ourselves, our talents, our minds, our inspirations, our hearts, our love, our light, is the most and the best that we can offer the world. It is what we are called to do for one another. The world will be better for our efforts, and our souls will sing.
take these words and songs we heard tonight home. Love one another. Let the little light in you shine.
Immerse yourself in the radiance of Christmas. Christmas can be more than a time or a season. Christmas can be our state of mind.
Cherish peace and goodwill, love, kindness, and mercy. Have the spirit and beauty of Christmas in your heart throughout this year. Let your light shine.